guys, and today this is, is it another video? I don't know. Oh no, this isn't my really favourite setup, so I'm gonna go to my other one. As the lighting suggests, this is a better spot. So yeah, basically, I'm ranking my top 10 favourite superheroes. I haven't got any honourable mentions or anything, I just decided to throw this list together. It's my opinion. It's not that I think everyone thinks like this, obviously. I know it's an unpopular opinion, my list. I'm gonna annoy a lot of people saying this. Number 10, Catwoman. Now, let me get started. People who don't read many comics, people who aren't like valid comic book readers, don't know Catwoman. Now, basically, she's changed, and her dynamic with Bruce in the new Batman series, which I have down there, I'll get an issue for reference. This is the first part of the story arc where he's getting married to Selina, well, engaged. This is like, basically, they have the wardrobe and all that, and basically, it sort of just makes the timeline. He just puts something on the timeline, like, they get married. Because they're getting married in issue 50. And it's just setting it up for, like, 20 issues is, like, really fun. So, you know, it's really good to see her as a hero, and that is my number 10 spot. And then number 9 is Deadpool. And this is mainly because of the movie, I'm just saying. Like, it's obvious. Like, Deadpool's movie just blew up and no one expected it to, like, you know, it was a big thing, like, you know, I was surprised that it blew up. I knew about the character beforehand, but he just blew up and I thought his character was just, like, different. I mean, you know, sorry, I just seem awkward in this video, you know, but yeah, he was just different to every other hero you probably ever see. I mean, yeah, you can have the odd same, but you know, that's what makes him good. In at number 8 is Kid Flash, and now I don't really care which Wally West you're talking about. You could be talking about Bart Allen. I'm not talking about Bart Allen, but I've got an issue here. Any Wally West is good, but honestly, I've got the recent issue of the Flash 40, and yeah, just, this is a character. He's really interesting because the dynamic, yes, there's a naked Barry Allen. The dynamic between him and Barry is just captivating. And like, the thing where he was forgotten and everything is so sad, and like, he lost his wife. I just think it's interesting for his character to do in this direction. Also, you have two Wally Wests, which can get confusing for some people, but I think it's interesting that they're making two Wally Wests. I think it's a choice that they made. So like, you can have a Kid Flash that can take over from Barry any time, and you have a Kid Flash that's like too small to get in Barry's suit and stuff. Like, he doesn't look as much like a Flash. Like, his suit's yellow, so you would think that's Kid Flash. But yeah. It's confusing. Coming in at 7 is Wonder Woman, and yet again, I'm not into her comics, but I think it was the impact of the movie. Like, the movie just, I'm usually a comic book guy, but I'm into the DCEU, honestly, and I'm into I'm into a lot of DC comics. Marvel can be alright, like Black Panther, but I think that her movie just, basically, it, like, changed stuff. Like, you have the original Superman. You have Batman 89, because, I mean, no one wants to talk about 66. But, yeah, and it's up there with, like, becoming her original film. Her Superman, classic Superman, Christopher Reeves, you know? Coming at number 6 is Red Hood, and the reason is, his character, he sort of just has a re- reasonable story where his motives make sense. He was a Robin, he was murdered by the Joker, and he came back. He was annoyed at Batman, obviously, because Batman let him die in an explosion. Or a crowbar, really, it's both, isn't it? And he was going to die if he was left there anyway. But and he wants revenge on Batman for letting him die, and also the Joker for killing him. So it's reasonable, his character act, that he wants to kill the Joker. And I don't know about Batman, if he wanted to kill Batman. But then he goes down this path of just becoming an anti-hero. And yeah, Jason Todd, honestly, good character. Next is Nightwing, and Dick Grayson has gone through a lot. He's been Robin, Nightwing, and Batman. But really, Nightwing was his prime moment when he sort of became his own superhero. Nightwing, like, him being Batman, I'm not a fan of people taking over roles, apart from Robin, because Robin has to stay as a kid. Because that's been a classic thing where you get new Robins, but like, the thing about, like, changing Captain America's in the comics, changing Batman, whatever, that, it just feels wrong. I think you should just, if Bruce Wayne dies, I think Batman dies. But when he becomes Nightwing, he just becomes his own hero. I'm not much into the comics. It's just, what you see in, like, in animation, you know, like Teen Titans films, the animated ones. Not Teen Titans Go. God damn, not Teen Titans Go. Okay, after that. Yeah. On to the next one. And number four is, this is going to be a weird choice for some people, Iceman. You're going to like be like, what the hell? Basically, Iceman, don't really know what it is. It's just like, basically, when I was a young kid, like 3 years old, I would have been, no, like 6 years old, I just thought Iceman was the coolest X-Men member in the old X-Men films. And actually, wait a second, one Mississippi, and that's a second, just threw something on the floor. Yeah, anyway, yeah, I've got an issue right here. It is Iceman issue 8. I'm not gonna collect the Iceman series. It's not a series that I'm like, oh my god, better pick that right off the shelf, Travy Bear. It's more of a thing I'll read. Like, I will read it, but the movies really captured him well. It's Iceman versus Iceman. Honestly, this captured me, the title, Iceman versus Iceman, and then I was actually really annoyed, because Iceman didn't fight Iceman, they were happy. I need to stop zooming in. So yeah, interesting. I shouldn't have thrown that. Right, on to number three. Number three is Superman. And really, you're shocked, aren't you? And Superman, really? I'll just show you his latest comic now. But I do have volume 1 and 2 reviews are up on my channel right now. This is my channel right now. But yeah. Yeah, they're up there. Volume 1, Son of Superman, and volume 2, Trials of the Super Son. Yeah, should be Super Sons, but you know, can't have Damian Wayne in the title. Or it's not a Superman book. Tomasi. Is that how you say it? Tomasi. That's the writer. He used to write it, doesn't he? Just write Super Sons now. I guess we'll never know. Oh, God damn. On to number two. So number two, I just flipped my thing up. Well, number two, it's got to be, this is gonna be like, who's number one, Travis? Number two is Batman. He used to be my favorite superhero. I do get his comics. I just show you the older one. Old. I'm gonna get another for reference. Let's see what's a good one. My first Batman issue. Batman number 21. This is the button part one. It was really good. Yeah. There's hairs in it. Sorry. Right. Yeah, so I really enjoyed this because it's Batman. Batman, you can't really go wrong with Batman. Well, you can go wrong with Batman. Same with Superman. God damn it, New 52. Sorry. But you know. Yeah. Batman 21. Better not be still going on that meme. Don't they go like... 21! Isn't that the big meme? Not funny. I think that's like 5 years old. Not five. But it's a few years old. Anyway, boys. Back again. Anyway. Yeah, Batman 21. Why am I reviewing Batman 21? It's about Batman. He's your second favorite superhero, Travis. I'm going off track. Yeah. Batman. Great character. Great villains. Especially the Riddler. Sorry, Joker. No hate. But you're not as good. And that's why Batman... dates the Riddler, not you, and not Catwoman. Batman's getting engaged to the Riddler. Hashtag, I have the news. Oh my god. The big DCEU news. That's supposed to be bad news, isn't good news. It's good news. It's good news. The Riddler and Batman are getting married. So in at number one, I have the gracious comic right here. Is... Batman. Jokes, it's The Flash. Your boy's there. Basically, yeah, this comic series is amazing. It got me into The Flash. And then, also the TV show. Amazing. I tell you. Amazing. It's amazing, you know. That TV show with Grant Turbo!